Wichita, ground citation 282 Whiskey Bravo with India Yingling for taxi.
Citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, Wichita ground, Juliet currents, wind 0705, altimeter 3009er, runway 1 right, taxi via Alpha Romeo Echo.
Alpha Romeo Echo to 1 right, and we'll pick up Juliet 2 Whiskey Bravo.
Citation 6 Juliet Kilo Tower now, 118.2, enjoy your day.
Juliet Kilo Roger, you too, yeah.
All right, here we go. That was absolutely some great service at Yingling here at Wichita. They turned us in 30 minutes without even knowing that we were coming. So that's a great turn, and we really appreciate that. So welcome aboard again, everybody. We are headed out of Wichita now, going to Napa Valley, Napa Airport. I think it's called Napa County Airport, Alpha Papa Charlie. All right, exterior lights. As we have steering's good, brakes are good. Flight instruments, everything's green. Alpha, Romeo, and Echo. Speed brakes are retracted and confirm retracted. Ground button is pushed. We should be on heading in takeoff mode. Romeo and Echo. Four, maintaining 5,026.7.
Station 2 Whiskey Bravo Tower now 118.2. Have a great day.
18.2. Have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo. Tower, citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, ready for departure, 1 right.
Citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, Wichita Tower, hold short of runway 1 right, be 1 moment for arriving traffic and departure off the parallel going the same way.
Hold short of 1 right to Whiskey Bravo.
Number 282 Whiskey Bravo, runway 1 right, line up and wait.
Line up and wait, 1 right, 2 Whiskey Bravo.
President 2556, turn left heading 320, contact departure.
Mist protection system.
Heading 320 to departure, Horizon Air 2556.
Pedo statics we'll get.
Station test 51, turn right or left, when
exterior
able, and contact ground 91 off, good day.
Mist right protection systems we don't need, pedo statics we'll get.
Number 282 Whiskey Bravo, turn left, heading 320, may 1 right, clear for takeoff, wind 0203.
Left turn 320, clear for takeoff, 1 right, 2 Whiskey Bravo. Power set, achieve 2 good engines. Airspeed's alive both sides. 70 knot cross check. Okay, Ponser 8 landing gear is coming up. We're ready, V2 plus 10. 400 feet, flaps up. We'll go autopilot, mean nav, flight level change. Left turn 320.
Traffic.
Traffic is on the ground.
Station 2 Whiskey Bravo, contact departure.
Over departure, have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo.
I am on a path indicating 2,500.
Departure citation 282 Whiskey Bravo 3,100, climbing 5,000, heading 320.
November 282 Whiskey Bravo, Wichita departure, radar contact, climb and maintain 10,000.
Up to 10,000, 2 Whiskey Bravo. I see 10,000. And let's go with the after takeoff checklist.
November 6 Juliet Kilo, contact Kansas City.
Landing gear is up. I've got no lights.
18-8, 6 Juliet Kilo, see ya.
November 2 Whiskey Bravo, turn left heading 270.
Left turn 270, 2 Whiskey Bravo. Flaps are zero, indicating zero. Throttles are in the climb detent. That's why we have the reminder.
Direct Gulf.
Passenger safety.
Right
switch. Turn that off. Recognition lights. Pressurization is climbing. Air conditioner is on low. After takeoff checklist is complete.
November 2 Whiskey Bravo, proceed direct Kyler.
Direct Kyler to Whiskey Bravo. Direct, and nav. So you see, there's a good reason. That's why you always back up with checklist. We have a 5-minute limitation on the power going to your climb detents, which is shown right here. And I accidentally did not bring them back.
November
That's why you back it up
turn,
with a checklist.
110.
You won't have a problem.
Okay, left 110, 403 Delta Papa.
And for those that that didn't catch it, I will pop up a graphic here, but this is climb, but it said TO. I never pulled the throttles back into the takeoff position. All right, I botched that explanation, so I'm pausing this flight to better describe what I caught. Since the CJ3 Plus uses FADEC to control the engines, there are 5 detents on the throttles: off, idle, cruise, climb, and takeoff. A digital representation is above each N1 gauge here. The white takeoff indicates the engines are awaiting takeoff power. On departure, you set your power to the takeoff detents, verify that your detent indicator changes to green, and that the engines are making assigned power by watching the cyan pointers change to solid green. I usually move the throttles out of the takeoff and into the climb detents around 1,000 feet, but obviously got distracted with the turn, frequency change, and climb. Going over the 5-minute takeoff limitation can be an expensive mistake, possibly requiring an engine teardown, and demonstrates the need for always backing up your flows with a checklist. Hopefully this better explains what I caught. Let me know if you'd like to see more content like this, and enjoy the rest of the flight. Thousand to go, leaving 9 for 10. Hopefully don't keep us down here too long at 10,000 feet. I'm guessing it's this traffic that's in our way right now.
November 3 Delta Papa, turn left hitting 045, intercept final, runway 1 left. November 3 Delta Papa, you're not cleared for approach. I'll have clearance for you momentarily.
Okay, cleared for the approach then, 403 Delta Papa.
November 2 Whiskey Bravo, maintain 15,000.
Climb maintain 15,000 to Whiskey Bravo.
November 3 Delta Papa, 4 miles in front of approach fix, maintain 3,000, till established on the localizer, cleared ILS, runway 1 left approach.
Okay, 3,000 until established, and cleared the ILS 1 left for 403 Delta Papa.
It looks like the weather wound up somewhat okay around the airport we're going to land at, which was in Gulf Charlie Kilo. And so we could have probably made it in there, but I'm not a big fan of the word probably in aviation, and there was no reason not to go ahead and land in Wichita.
November 3 Delta Papa, contact Tower 118.2.
Okay, 118.2, 403 Delta Pop.
November 2, Whiskey Bravo, contact Kansas City Center, 118.8, we'll see ya.
18.8, have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo. Kansas City Center, citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, 13,800, climbing 15,000.
Station 282 Whiskey Bravo, Kansas City Center, climb maintain flight level 230.
Climb maintain flight level 230, 2 Whiskey Bravo.
Whiskey Bravo, expect light chop in the mid-30s anyway, out towards Dodge, New York City, with the weather, looking up the aviation.
Whiskey Bravo, roger. Okay, we are on flight level change. And another good thing is to always check your, what I call the scoreboard, others call bingo board, or any time you touch something on the autopilot up here, you want to make sure that it shows up
here.
Otherwise, the airplane's not doing what you think it's doing.
Actually, you're going to be outbound. Your climb-out instructions will be direct Hutchinson up 5,000. And appreciate changes approved.
So really appreciate you guys coming along with me again. We're past out of 15,800. There's not much to see, do, or talk about at the moment, so we're going to go ahead and shut the cameras down now, and we'll pick them back up on the way into Napa Valley, California. Thanks for coming along, and we'll see you soon. Everybody, welcome back. We're level at flight level 280 now. Probably start down in the next 10 minutes. They gave us a little bit of a reroute here, and we're coming over top of Lake Tahoe at the moment. Lake Tahoe, flight level 280. The winds are out of the southwest in Napa, so they're landing on 19 right. And I'm guessing, this is my first time out here, but I'm guessing that they route people over Tahoe and Cigna and then straight in toward the runway to keep everybody out of Oakland's airspace. So it's been a pretty uneventful flight. We got to see a couple cool things. Got to see Area 51, which is kind of cool. I've been to Tahoe one time, but I just drove around it. I went to the Reno Air Races probably about 20 years ago. Kind of sucks that this is their last year in Reno. On one of the days we were out in Reno, we decided to drive out and around Lake Tahoe.
Number 12 Golf Tango, Oakland Center.
This is the first time I've seen it from the air, though. It's pretty cool. Oddly enough, there's no approaches to 19er right or 19er left. We wouldn't be using 19er left. It's too short. There's no approaches to 19er right. And one cool thing here about the G3000 is you can actually set up a visual to 19er right. So we have visual. I'm gonna switch this to vectors. You can put minimums in if you want. I'll put 200 feet, but it's clear there right now. And we'll go ahead and load this. And it just warns you that obstacle clearance is not provided for visual approaches. So you can't rely on it for obstacle clearance. You shouldn't use it for approach, but it'll at least give me a 3-degree glide path to the runway. So we'll go ahead and load that. And then we can scroll over here and just take a quick peek at it. See, what it does is it puts in a straight in leg here and to run a 19er right. And if you look at it on the GTCs here, it just gives you a straight in vector and expects you to be at 720 feet, 2.5 miles out. And it will provide
November 140 Hotel, contact Oakland Center 121.
It will provide a glide path for you, which is pretty cool. Yeah, coming over Lake Tahoe is really cool, all the snow that's out here. I'm probably going to take a trip out here while I'm in San Francisco or in Napa Valley. If anybody has frequented out here, let me know what I need to see next time I come out here. I'm doing all the touristy stuff because I haven't been out to California. I'm going to go to Alcatraz, go see a baseball game, and then probably Yosemite. I might go down to Monterey too. And obviously, gotta see the Golden Gate Bridge. I like to, when I go on flights like this that I've never been, I'm the tourist. I pick things to do and go have some fun.
November 282 Whiskey Bravo, contact Oakland Center 134.97.
3497, have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo.
Good day.
Oakland Center, citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, flight level 280.
Citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, center low.
They started us down pretty early here. Looks like I'm going to land with probably 1,100 or 1,200 pounds of fuel here. 45 minutes for flight planning purposes is 900 pounds at low altitude. I generally don't like getting too much lower than 1,200 pounds, but I know the weather is perfectly clear out here today, and that's we'll probably land with about 1,100 pounds. You can see fuel over destination is 1070 right now. If the weather was bad, we would have made a second stop.
Good afternoon, runway 382 Juliet Heavy, maintaining flight level 370.
Bus 382 Juliet Heavy, Oakland Center, Roger.
So we should be landing with a little bit over an hour of fuel when I flight plan for it.
Whiskey Bravo, descent pilot's discretion, maintain flight level 24024.
Pilot's discretion, flight level 2402 Whiskey Bravo. So when I flight plan, I actually put an alternate in of Charles Schultz Airport in
the 2443 descent and
the full route, including going to our alternate. Would have left us with just under 1,000 pounds. So we give it pilot's discretion, flight level 240. So I've put it in the marker there, and what will happen is in 3 minutes, we're going to start down on a 3-degree glide path to flight level 240. And that glide path is based on me in our flight plan down here, putting I want to be at 2,000 feet, 5 miles short of Napa County.
Whiskey Bravo, contact Oakland Center, 132.2.
32.2, have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo.
Good day. Oh, sure,
1771, 102 Bravo.
Oakland Center, citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, flight level 280, pilot's discretion 240.
32 Whiskey Bravo, Oakland Center, good afternoon.
We're making our turn, Center, inbound now. Top of descent in 2 minutes.
Oakland Southwest 1700, climbing 5190.
Southwest 2681, Oakland Center, good afternoon. Climb maintain flight level 230.
We should be on the ground in 20 minutes.
Climb maintain flight level 230, Southwest 2681.
Okay, to Whiskey Bravo, descend and maintain flight level 200.
Descend maintain flight level 200 to Whiskey Bravo. All right, I'm going to set it to 200. We're going to intercept a path here, so I'll just let that start taking me down. Turn my defogs on to get ready for... All right, and there is path capture. Fog I just turned on. Bleed airs, don't think we're going to need. Fuel balance, we're pretty balanced, and pressurization is 36.
Southwest 2681, contact Oakland Center 134.97.
Descent checklist complete, transition altitude to go.
Jesse Bravo, contact NorCal approach 125.4, good afternoon.
25.4, have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo. NorCal approach, citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, flight level 248, descending 200 with Foxtrot.
Number 282 Whiskey Bravo, NorCal approach, descend maintain 14,000, Sacramento altimeter 2981.
2981 and 14,000 to Whiskey Bravo. This is my first time flying a plane across the Rockies.
And November 3205,
that was
terminate.
Pretty cool views, lots of snow. Hopefully the videos came out well.
Approach, and then we would go direct to realistic before they came off.
Tower 3 Tango Alpha, roger.
But once you get across the Rockies, then there's a lot of nothing.
Winter will help the airport site, South 3119.
Southwest 3119 at Bowman, cleared to visual approach 2017 right.
After 01E, cleared for the visual 17 right, South 3119.
Over Sacramento right now.
Southwest 2236, that's field site.
Southwest 2236, clear as approach, runway 17 right.
Visual 17 right, Southwest 2236.
Thousand feet to go, leaving 15, descending 14.
Approach Southwest 267, 6000, descended via the Center 4 field site.
Southwest 267, recalibrate approach, send maintain 3000, expect your approach clearance shortly.
3000, Southwest 267.
Number 2, Whiskey Bravo, contact over center 125.85.
2585, have a good day, Whiskey Bravo. Oakland Center, citation 282, Whiskey Bravo, 14000 with Gulf.
282, Whiskey Bravo, Oakland Center, descend and maintain 7000.
Descend maintain 7000 to Whiskey Bravo. Right, down to 7. We'll do vertical speed. 2,200 feet a minute to stay on, or to get down to our
5-5-6,
and that
closet.
Is right here.
Closet,
just 10,000 feet. We'll go seatbelts on and start the approach checklist. Passenger safety switch is on seatbelt. Landing data is 106 and 98. Crew briefing is complete. Approach, we're
going to
be a visual approach.
Roger, medevac 842, my problem 1600. Climb the Aussie 4X, maintaining 6000.
Avionics flight instruments are set, medevac field transfer is off, and we are balanced. Exterior lights are on recox. Passenger briefing.
My problem.
We're ready
to
do
Whiskey Bravo, descend maintain 5000.
Descend maintain 5000 to Whiskey Bravo. Alright, down to 5000. We'll check our now here in 1 second. Messages, we have no messages.
7-1-2-6-7-5-3-1-0 to 7-5-5.
So we need 1900 feet a minute. So I'm going to shallow this out a little bit. I've been told by a few people that they like to slam dunk in here, but I guess, you know, especially if you're landing to the southwest, you have the mountains to come over here, come over top of.
R22 Whiskey Bravo, Napa is 12 o'clock and about 10 miles, advise and say.
Still looking, Whiskey Bravo.
2 Whiskey Bravo, roger, turn 10 degrees to the right.
10 degrees right, 2 Whiskey Bravo. Okay.
Good afternoon,
Center.
Center,
Bennett,
337 Victor, level
9.5,
Napa.
Procedure.
334
Victor, Oakland Center, Napa, Center, 88.
Center, 88,
7 Victor. Medevac 2 Mike Bravo,
clear
Jessica.
Clear Jessica, 2 Mike Bravo.
Oakland 2 Whiskey Bravo has the airport in sight.
2 Whiskey Bravo clear visual approach 19 right.
They're
autopilot.
Clear visual 19 right. 2 Whiskey
autopilot.
Bravo.
Autopilot.
556 contact NorCal approach 133.95.
3395.
I'm dumping the gear out just to slow down here quickly because we're pretty high.
569 Echo it's Bravo, radar contact over Skaggs Island 6000. Clear to Las Vegas as filed, with climb and maintain flight level. Climb and maintain 10,000.
Clear to Las Vegas as filed, maintain 10,000, and leaving 6400 now, 9 next level.
2 Whiskey Bravo, radar service terminate, contact Napa Tower 118.7.
Over to Tower, have a good day, 2 Whiskey Bravo. Napa Tower, citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, visual 19 right.
Citation 282 Whiskey Bravo, Napa Tower, make straight in runway 19 right, cleared to land. Traffic approaching a wide left downwind at midfield at 1,500 for the parallel runway. Archer.
2 Whiskey Bravo, clear to land runway 19 right.
Okay, the 3 Tango Hotel, cross the turn approved.
Flaps 35.
Approved 743 Tango Hotel.
Landing gear is down, I got 3 green, flaps are 35, speed brakes are retracted. And confirm retracted. This is a pretty steep approach coming in here. And we'll go approach. go around altitude. We'll just stick 2,000 in there since this is a visual. Airspeed cross checks are 130 both sides. Passenger safety switch and landing light are both on. Beautiful approach in here. Steeper than normal, but I read a little bit about it.
Citation 2, Whiskey Bravo, that traffic for the parallel runway Cherokee is approaching their left base track.
Whiskey Bravo still looking for traffic. Traffic inside Whiskey Bravo.
Cessna 3 Tango Hotel, your number 2 following the Archer turning final, runway 19 left cleared for the option, traffic for the parallel 2 mile final, citation.
19 left clear for the option. Traffic inside 743 Tango Hotel.
$500.
Gear down 3 green. Pressurization's 0.3. Yacht ammeter's disengaged. And we are confirmed clear to land.
Minimums.
A little gusty there right at the end. We have arrived.
Citation 2, Whiskey Bravo, left turn on until contact ground.
Left turn and contact ground to Whiskey Bravo.
542 Kilo, number 2, found Cessna short final, runway 19 left, clear flash.
Number 2, clear to the option, 19 left.
There we go, we got 1,300 pounds of fuel, which is what I said we'd land with. Lights coming up, lights.
Citation 282, Whiskey Bravo, Napa Ground, taxi to Atlantic via Hotel Charlie Alpha 2.
Hotel Charlie Alpha 2, to Whiskey Bravo. Hotel Charlie Alpha 2. Pretty gusty here, smacking my controls around. Well, thank you everybody for coming along. Another nice flight. We've arrived in Napa Valley, California. And thanks for coming along. If you feel like you're having fun with these videos, please give me a like and a subscribe. And we'll catch you on the next flight. Thank you.